everyone and welcome to another installment of the Ducted Fan series. My earlier EDF has been revised and a new case with fixed stator blades has been constructed. I'll be comparing 6 different propellers in this video. Here's the EDF SCAD model complete with all its pieces. The redesigned casing design with fixed stator blades is also visible. The files can be downloaded using the link provided in the description. Let's get start putting the EDF together. All the parts were 3D printed with a layer height of 0.2mm and a 30% infill. For propellers and outer casing, use support generation. Take a nose plier and wire cutter to remove the supports. Remove the support from the blades with the wire cutter. Because the blades are narrow, take caution while removing the supports. Remove the center support with the nose plier, so grab the support and twist it in both the directions. Once it gets loose, it can be easily pulled out. Then remove the left out supports using a nose plier. After removing the support, you will get a clean part. If they are not smooth, trim the blade edges with a sandpaper. I will be comparing 6 different propellers. So here is the 6 blade propeller, the 11 blade one, the 8 blade one, the 3 blade one, and here is the 4th blade propeller. I have reduced the propeller pitch as so many of you have commented in the previous video. This is my previous design which has a higher pitch blade, but on seeing the new design, you can clearly see the pitch difference. I have reduced the pitch. This is the new case of the EDF. It has a set of 6 fixed blades. While 3D printing the EDF, make sure to provide the support. So take a nose plier to remove the support, or you can simply twist it with your hands. Then grab the center support and pull it out. After removing the support material, the outer casing will look like this. Since I was not sure about the pitch angle of the stator blade, I designed another EDF with a low pitch angle blade. This case is of the higher pitch angle blade and this one is of the lower pitch angle blade. So now we will compare both of them and use the most efficient one. This is the EDF holder which is used to fix the EDF to the test rig. Now we will compare both the casings for higher efficiency. First, I will test the lower pitch casing. To secure it to its mount, use 8 screws of 8mm length and 2.5mm diameter. I'll be using this 2500kV motor which I used in my previous version 2. Now we will attach the motor to the casing. So take the motor and the casing and align the screw holes. Then fix them with M3 screws of 8mm length. If you haven't checked out my previous video of 80mm EDF, then click on the I button. Here is the 6 blade propeller for the thrust test, so I will fix it on the motor. So take out the motor nut and fix the propeller on the top. And as you can see, there is a gap between the motor thread and the propeller. So I am using this washer to overcome that distance. Now tighten the nut and fix the propeller. This is the test rig I am going to use. Check out the test rig video by clicking on the I button. So just fix this EDF with the test rig using 2 screws of 40mm length. In my previous video, you saw me using this 11.1 volt 3000mAh old battery, but now I will be using this 8000mAh battery. Before performing the test, I will check the battery voltage to ensure maximum thrust. And it's around 12.3 volts. Now connect the servo tester and attach the battery. Now start the throttle using the servo tester. We get a maximum thrust of 315 grams. Now I will switch to a higher pitch casing. Now I will use this high pitched stator casing for the test. Now I will recheck the battery voltage to ensure test similarity. And it's around 12.3 volts. Now connect the battery and start the test. This time we get a maximum thrust of 325 grams, which is about 10 grams more than the previous one. Even though 10 grams seems a small increment, but on increasing the voltage of the battery, it will have a huge impact. So now we will be using the high-pitched blade casing for the test. So until I disassemble this EDF, you can watch one of my cool robotic projects. This is a mechanical wheel robot which has a robotic arm mounted on its top. This robot can perform various tasks while moving in all the directions. It is wirelessly controlled through an Android app. So guys, do check out this video by clicking on the I button and don't forget to subscribe for more videos like this. Now we'll not be using this low pitch blade casing. And on comparison, these both look similar but have different efficiencies. This was my previous EDF without the stator blades and has a total maximum thrust of 265 grams, so we don't need to test it. Now let's begin the thrust test. So I'll be starting with the 3 blade propeller as so many of you have suggested in the comment section. First, I calculated the force required to lift the EDF in the mid position. It weighs around 190 grams. Connect the battery and after the motor beeps, start the throttle. And if the propeller is rotating in the opposite direction, then swap any two wires like in my case. Now I have swapped the wire and started the throttle. We get a maximum thrust of 260 grams at 14.13 amperes. And on adding EDF weight, we get a total thrust of 450 grams at 14.13 ampere. Now I will replace the battery with a 4S battery. So let's check its voltage. It's around 16.7 volts, which means it's fully charged. So I connected the battery and started the test. We get a total thrust of 720 grams at 20.39 ampere. Well, it's a massive increase in thrust as compared to a 3S battery. Now it's time to test the 4 blade propeller. So mount it in its casing. Now I have connected the battery and started the test. At 15.43 ampere, we get a total thrust of 390 grams. And now I will change the battery and check the thrust. We get a total thrust of 725 grams at 21.83 amperes. Now I will swap this propeller with the 5-bladed one. Now fix this 5 blade propeller on the EDF. Now connect the battery and start the test. I am using this 8000 mAh battery, so I don't need to recharge it again and again after the test. At 16.82 ampere, we get a total thrust of 510 grams. Now I will change the battery and calculate the thrust. We got a total thrust of 780 grams at 24.50 ampere. Now I will replace this propeller with a 6-bladed one. This is the 6-bladed propeller that I'm going to use, so mount it on the EDF. Now connect the battery and start the throttle. The total thrust we got is 540 grams at 17.95 ampere. Now I will swap this battery and check the thrust on a 4S battery. At 25.49 ampere, we obtained a total thrust of 805 grams. Now it's time to replace this propeller with the 8-bladed one. This is the 8-bladed propeller that I'm going to use, so attach it on the EDF. Now connect the battery and start the test. We get a total thrust of 495 grams at 18.87 ampere. And now I will check the thrust with a 4S battery. We get a total thrust of 755 grams at 26.64 ampere. Now remove the battery and we will replace this propeller with the 11-bladed one. This is the 11-bladed propeller that I'm going to use. Earlier, I used a 12-bladed one, but someone suggested to use the odd number of blades to prevent symmetrical axial vibration, which can cause self-destruction. Now connect the battery and test the thrust. The total thrust we get is 470 grams at 19.80 ampere. Now I will replace this battery with the 4S battery and check the thrust. The total thrust we get is 705 grams at 28.05 ampere. Here our thrust test is over of all the propellers. Now it's time for the observation part. So here are the test results which we have obtained from the thrust test. We are now discussing the 3S battery. The 3-bladed propeller is highly efficient. It produced 450 grams of thrust at an efficiency of 2.61, while the 6-bladed propeller produced 540 grams at an efficiency of 2.48. Now talking about the 4S battery, the 3-bladed propeller again proves to be highly efficient. It produced 720 grams of thrust at an efficiency of 2.3, while the 6-bladed propeller produced a maximum thrust of 805 grams at an efficiency of 2.07. Thus, we can say that the 3-bladed and 6-bladed propellers are recommended for our design, as they are efficient as well as produce the maximum thrust, so we can eliminate the other designs. Though 8-blade and 11-blade propellers have more blades than a 6-blade propeller, but they didn't perform well in this scenario because more motor requires more motor torque, but our motor has high RPM and low torque. So this could be one of the possible reasons. So thank you all for recommending that I reduce the propeller pitch and use stator blades, because it made a significant difference in thrust and efficiency when compared to the previous video. I have also tried some more propeller designs like this one. This is a 6-bladed propeller that has straight blades. I have designed it for this 1000 kV motor, but it performs so poorly that it can't lift its own weight. The same thing happened with this 8-blade propeller. None of them performed well. This was another design for a 1000 kV motor. This motor gets completely wrapped in this propeller and all these blades are identical to the new design blades. But the problem was with the motor RPM. And here is another design. This propeller doesn't wrap around the motor and sit on it. The problem with this propeller is that it is closer to the opening and thus produces less thrust. As you can see, there was a big gap in its position. I also designed and 3D printed this nozzle, which can be fitted at the back of the EDF. I tested it, but it had no effect on the thrust, so I didn't upload the result. This was my previous ducted fan, but the new design is more efficient and produces more thrust. So our project is finished, and please continue to support my channel for more videos like this. And don't forget to subscribe and hit the like button. And if you have any suggestions, then do comment in the comment section. So thanks for watching and have a nice day.